I'm just doing a brief message. I'm doing my career mode, Shawn Michaels, American, and yeah, no copyright included, but I'm making this video to say the reason why I haven't been uploading is because probably like for a past few days I lost my internet, and yeah. And yesterday I really didn't, I was like talking to my friends to get catch up on them. For this video, I wanna. Alright, you guys might hear some commentary, but I'll try talking over them.
I don't think I need to give a history lesson, but I'll remind everyone that Bad News Barrett is a natural born leader.
I'm just
he led factions the Nexus.
What's up, bro?
And is obsessed with ruling the ring and winning WWE Championship gold.
Like I said, if you, I probably will be doing a face reveal later. Don't really have the equipment right now.
Figuring out what they're going to do next.
Me too. I've given up even trying to figure out what they're going to do next. Oh man, from the high rim district.
I don't know what that's like. What's your analysis of Barrett?
What hasn't been said already? Everybody's talking.
I'll probably be doing a live stream with Eric later if he's on.
Here. Let's just sit back and enjoy.
Tell me if you're on, Eric. I will be coming out with some gameplay, like do my career.
So much it's going to take a minor
but
miracle to keep one of them down.
There we go. You're on right now? Okay.
Incoming,
we'll do a live stream later.
Look out below! Look out!
Can you stop me? I'm probably getting this live stream after this match. I'm gonna start up a new live stream from 2K Showcase, probably.
Barrett is locked up.
Okay. Oh yeah, Eric, remember that live stream? I got like over 200 comments.
By the sound of this crowd, I think they're getting what they wanted.
Not today, too fast.
A lot of momentum behind that flying forearm.
Yeah, damn, can you stop me?
That was good. Heads up! Take a chance like that. Do you know how badly he must want to win this?
I don't know why I keep diving like that. I should lock more points, but
Barrett gets rocked. Damage did that do?
But after I get going with Nick Max, I'll show you
he just got laid out.
What Shawn Michaels has done in his my career. This is like a new project that I'm working on.
Bare knuckle brawler. Bad News Barrett can stand up and go toe to toe with literally
I think I pre-recorded it. I'm just not putting it out for a while.
I don't think I've ever met a more cocky individual than Bad News Barrett. Oh, that'll knock the wind out of you.
I'll show you a finisher. I don't have the corner one yet because this is all I got. You get like option to join the authority, but I said no.
One of them also accepting defeat.
Because on my thing, I really don't like the authority.
He's delivering an old-fashioned butt-kicking right here.
Clapping face. Clapping face. Alright. Let me show you his moves. He got screeching music. He got the diving elbow. And he got the sharpshooter.
King, earlier you mentioned many of Bad News Barrett's admirable qualities. Let's not forget that Barrett's callous, arrogant, brash, and his menacing mentality helped him create the Barrett Barrage.
Wade has so many ways of mauling an
opponent. Oh, I can't do it right now. I don't think.
From WWE into one of those Barrett.
There's the diving
elbow
drop.
I didn't even think I could get that.
Alright. And what a hard knockdown, big time impact.
We'll try this. Should it work? Hey, Eric, have you been caught? That racist? Really? Really? Damn it, I hate. This is why you don't have friends. Fuck
now,
friends.
Okay, you can take a breath.
I swear, they better, like, change the commentary for next year, because the commentary is ass.
Ribs in the lower back. That just takes all of the power out of it. And I'd love to disagree with you on your earlier statement.
Yo, why'd you reverse, dude?
Right. Anybody who loves delivering bad news as much as Barrett does is
damn
undoubtedly
it.
A jerk.
I tried doing that.
Making it look easy.
Oh, shit. Bad New Barry isn't that bad, but like my guy's only like a 60 overall because
each
I really don't
competitors is looking for the
upgrade him.
Hit of weakness in the other. Well, that's a strategy you have to always have in the back of your head, Cole. If you ever see a weakness in your opponent,
come on.
You gotta jump on it. The more punishment he takes, the slower and slower he is getting back to his feet.
Bad New Barry, where you going?
There's the sound of sweet
yeah.
chin music.
Oh, replay.
Near. Yeah, the end of this party. Turn out the lights. The party's over. Covers.
What was the message? Like, I just wanted to explain why I haven't been uploading that much. But I want to thank everybody for all the views, all the subscribers and everything. I'm already at 13. I don't expect to get much, but at least I'm getting some. Watch the replay.
You want to talk about incredible?
See, the replays are not even that good.
Check out what happened during this match.
Like, I charged it up a little bit, and then it canceled. That's all.
Here's your winner, Shawn Michaels.
You heard the ring announcer. This one's over. And here's your...
commentary's ass, though. Okay. Like, I started uploading my career mode, like, a while, probably a few months ago, but I never got back to it because I really never thought people were really watching, so I didn't start doing it. So you can hear me. Who wins? Of course. A core cryback one. Yeah. Okay. Wow, my friend just lagged. Okay. Now let me show you. Alright. So I had to beat all these guys to get up to number 4. 4 out of 10. It's really hard. I won the Intercontinental Natural that's it. I haven't won the United States. I haven't won any of these. I'm not gonna get this until we get some money in the bank. That's when I cash in and shit. Alright. Since we're in a live stream, let me do something. I'm gonna start up the 2K showcase and I'm gonna edit my video player, try to. I really have the mechanics. I already beat all of it, so yeah. No copyright, yeah, help. We can always do that. Alright. Show Kyle's on. I can play on easy, I don't know. You can judge me all you want. Alright.
Showcase. A stage to display one's talents. From the unforgettable moments.
Mankind has achieved his dream!
This is home.
On the biggest stage.
The boyhood dream!
What did we just see?
Daniel Bryan did it! The Miracle Kid!
To the greatest conflicts. From the biggest names. But this showcase is about a man who became a legend.
The men
named Stone Cold Steve Austin.
After learning his craft from gentleman Chris Adams, Austin would begin his career in 1989.
I've been very impressed by Steve Austin's ability. He's showing that he has the potential to go a long, long way.
In 1991, the nation got their first glimpse of the future.
From Hollywood, California, 253 pounds, stunning Steve Austin.
Dominating, overpowering, arrogant.
When you bring two world-class athletes together and they mesh as one, you create an unbeatable machine.
And we will be unstoppable as a team. Count on it.
But despite his success, no one saw a superstar. And when injuries sidelined Steve, the future looked bleak.
Next day, I got a FedEx announcement that I was fired. I was like, that kind of sucked.
Frustration took over.
There's nothing going my way because the politics kept the biggest potential superstar in wrestling on the ground.
Frustration turned to anger.
We're going to put the U.S. title on you, and then we're going to take you here, and then you're the number one contender, so then you got this world title shot. Well, all that's never happened.
And anger created opportunity.
The ringmaster seems to really have it all. The size, the strength, the agility, the wrestling acumen.
Austin would enter WWE as the ringmaster, but wasted no time turning himself into a more ruthless character.
His peers dubbed him the ringmaster. I would suggest to you, from the look on his face and his attitude, he's a stone cold, if anything.
His moment was finally here.
It's on to bigger and better things after King of the Ring, after I win it all.
And nothing would be the same again.
Damn, that was actually pretty sweet. Whew.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, the King of the Ring, Stone Cold Steve Austin, awaits that man. And King, that man, Jake the Snake Roberts, earlier tonight took on Vader.
Oh, man.
It was not a good outing for the Snake.
He got scars in more ways than one. Watch this big Vader bomb. It's lucky there wasn't just a great spot left in the ring.
450 pounds doing internal damage. To what degree, we don't know, but Jake Roberts struggling to even get his reptile bag up on the apron of the ring, and Jake gingerly walking into the ring. This is a one-fall match in the King of the competition, and the Rattlesnake showing that he is wanting to end this quickly and convincingly.
Oh, look at this, JR. What's he doing to him?
He's stomping a mud hole at Jake the Snake, and now he is walking it dry. Nothing but high impact intensity. From a relentless, unforgiving, Stone Cold Steve Austin.
He's pounded poor Jake the Snake like a tent stake. No stopping the Rattlesnake here.
Austin is not going to give any opportunity for Jake Roberts to fight his way back into this match. Nothing pretty about Austin's offense, but it's very effective.
Oh, man, here goes.
Austin off that second turnbuckle, driving his elbows into the sternum, the ribs of Jake the Snake Roberts.
Oh, man. I don't know if poor Jake the Snake is going to be
able to get that goose feet. It doesn't even
directed
show.
Toward the rope snip.
His strike hits nothing but air. Nice.
There's supposed to be like a loading screen on it. I think that happens in like second. Like in second part. I want to push you in a suplex, I think. Ooh,
I'm not
Donger.
So sure that Gorilla Monsoon necessarily made the best decision by allowing Jake the Snake Roberts to come back out here and compete in this matchup.
We all know Monsoon is notorious for making stupid decisions.
He didn't need a GPS to find the mark.
The Yamek is the worst. I didn't want to go for his head, but okay.
Doing an excellent job dominating this match.
And he rushed.
With a 180.
That's
Jake
okay.
The Snake Roberts, the reverse.
You ain't got that many reverses left, and look how many
he
I got.
Attack misses.
This guy. Come on, come on. Hit me. Hit me, you. Are you serious?
He's got him. Jake the Snake Roberts.
He just got. Is that seriously? Okay.
He needs to figure out a way to get to his base and break the hold.
Ah, both of these men gutting it out here tonight, JR.
They'll do anything to earn the title of King of the Ring. A spectacular counter by
Steve
Austin. Come
on. I want to get that counter.
No, wait. Nice reversal.
Knee to the face.
That landed like a ton of bricks. Watch out. Oh, what's he going to do to follow that up?
With the gunner already? Are we just going to finish this off like that?
Nails his face.
Let's see what moves he has. I can't really remember. Oh, he got okay. I'll use the 360.
He's in full-on attack mode now.
That's what he's all about. I can't really do it. You know, I'm just gonna give that elbow drop, I guess.
Oh, this isn't good. Oh my, Steve Austin.
Okay, let me get that gamma a bit.
Uh-oh, he's in position, ready to strike.
The King of the Ring Finals continues here, Stone Cold Steve Austin.
Stunner! Stunner!
With a stunner on Jake the Snake Roberts. And the referee counts as 3, and Austin has beaten Jake the Snake Roberts.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of this bout, and now reigning King of the Ring, Stone Cold Steve Austin.
And there you see Stone Cold Steve Austin,
the new King of the Ring for 1996. Man, this was some battle, JR.
Austin went through some tough guys to finally get to the top of the mountain. There you see him. What is next for Stone Cold Steve Austin?
I'm just wondering how the Rattlesnake's gonna look with a crown on his head.
Yeah, he'll even wear it. I wonder if this is the beginning of bigger things for Stone Cold Steve Austin.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, the fourth prestigious King of the Ring, Stone Cold Steve Austin, an incredible victory.
The first thing I want to be done is to get that piece of crap out of my ring. Don't just get him out of the ring, get him out of the WWE. Because I've proved, son, without a shadow of a doubt, you ain't got what it takes anymore. You sit there and you thump your Bible and you say your prayers, and it didn't get you anywhere. Talk about your Psalms, talk about John 3:16. Austin 3:16 says, I just whipped your ass.
Oh, that's not necessary.
All he's got to do is go buy him a cheap bottle of and try to dig back some of that courage he had in his pride. As the King of the Ring, I'm serving notice to every one of the WWE superstars. I don't give a damn what they are. They're all on the list, and that's Stone Cold's list, and I'm fixing to start running through all of them. As far as this championship match is considered, son, I don't give a damn if it's Davey Boy Smith or Shawn Michaels. Steve Austin's time has come, and when I get the shot, you're looking at the next WWE champion, and that's the bottom line, because Stone Cold said so.
Obviously anything but humble, the fourth prestigious King of the Ring, Stone Cold Steve Austin.
Damn. Steve Austin actually is pretty good.
Austin 316 says, I just whipped your ass. As the King of the Ring, I'm serving notice to every one of the superstars. They're all on the list, and I'm fixing to start running through all of them. Steve Austin's time has come, and that's the bottom line, because Stone Cold said so.
Oh, wait a minute, look at that. Cheap shot. Oh, Stone Cold Stunner. Oh, there you go.
Stone Cold continued to scratch names off his superstar hit list, there was one name that had eluded Austin's sights.
I'd like to use this chance to issue a challenge against one Bret the Hitman Hart.
Bret Hart had been absent for the dawn of 316, and the man who had been raising hell all over WWE.
If you put the letter S in front of Hitman, you've had my exact opinion of Bret Hart. I'm the best there is.
I don't pay attention to a lot of talk.
I'm the best there was.
Especially when it comes from you.
And I'm the best there ever will be.
The Hitman found himself in unfamiliar territory, the crosshairs of the Texas Rattlesnake.
The one thing that's been missing has been me.
But the excellence of execution has never been one to back down from a challenge.
In the Survivor Series, I will face Stone Cold Steve Austin.
You're never gonna get through with Stone Cold Steve Austin. You're gonna have to kill me first, son, and that's the bottom line, and it's the truth.
And if I can beat Stone Cold, then I will beat Stone Cold. The rest is easy pickings for the Hitman.
Son, if you think Stone Cold Steve Austin is a stepping stone, well, watch the first step, cause it's a doozy.
Will Bret Hart be able to prove once and for all that he is the best there is, the best there was, and the best there ever will be?
We'll see who kicks whose ass.
Or will Austin 316 stomp the Hitman into exile?
You ain't got what it takes anymore.
Don't call. Okay.
Well, this should be quite the contest, Jerry. Stone Cold Steve Austin, Bret the Hitman Hart, finally going to meet one-on-one. This is a rivalry that has been brewing for several weeks now.
Well, you're right about that, JR. A long time coming, and it's finally here. Stone Cold Steve Austin, the Rattlesnake, going against the best there is, best there was, best there ever will be. This should be great.
Bret the Hitman Hart, the consummate wrestler. Scientific, fundamentally sound. Austin likes to brawl. Likes to fight.
Oh, look at this. Look at this stare down. Are either one of these guys going to be intimidated, JR?
I don't think so. Austin trying to get into Hart's head. I don't think that's going to happen.
Look at that.
Oh, my goodness. You're number one in the Hart of Stone Cold Steve Austin.
Here they go.
The black heart of the Texan. Connor Nabotaya.
It's an airsoft.
Bret the Hitman Hart will have the advantage momentarily. Austin now reverses it. Referee asks for a clean break.
Whoa. Uh-oh. I wouldn't want to be the referee in this match, would you, JR?
Absolutely not.
Uh-oh. I think timbers are going to flare really quick.
Well, the tension. You could feel the tension when these men came to the ring. You knew this was going to be
vintage Steve Austin right there.
Steve Austin used the sharpshooter to make Bret Hart submit.
I guess she was Shawn Michaels. Boy. Okay, let's do this. Here's something in the background like my stupid little brother. Don't really want
Steve
him in my
Austin
room, but can't do
anything.
Okay, I can't really get him on the ropes.
Man,
I gotta get my
talk about putting a target on someone's back.
Just get me up,
well,
Brett. See what happens.
Didn't expect that to happen.
Oh, and a terrific reversal by Steve Austin.
Boy, I'm Stone Cold.
Hits the mat.
I didn't want him to submit, but.
Oh, that'll leave a mark. Not the most effective striking here.
Okay, there he is. There you go. There he is, right here. I actually like this better than 2K15, where it would,
man,
like, take forever.
Here. Look at this!
Yeah, Bret Hart, he won't quit! He doesn't know how to quit!
Wow! Austin's just opening a can! Steve Austin with the offense.
Yeah. can of whoop ass. If you guys are wondering why I said what's up later, I said what's up to Brian, Pretty, one of my friends. Well, not. He just commented on my video one time, so I said hi. Stone Cold, D-Boston. Oh, that's pretty cool. They have King and JR. They also have the Spanish cable. I haven't seen that in a while. Like, looks like
he wants this battle decided back inside the ring.
They don't even have Spanish cables anymore.
And
I don't think
the action back
they used to.
The ring.
That's why I hate it. And, like, they never had. They barely
had
it.
He had a personal trainer to help himself get ready.
Yeah, you're right.
Ooh.
All of his old nagging injuries should be fully healed at this point. If he keeps up this pace, this could turn real ugly real fast.
He knows how to get you in his cut.
Wait, what is it? I don't know what that means.
Just
oh, it means the
impossible to get out of.
Oh man, I wouldn't be surprised to see that eye swell up after that.
Bret Hart being overwhelmed here.
Steve Austin making his statement as we speak.
I don't get that at all. Is it using the target or move in the direction? Hit the flying. I didn't
looking
go
for all the glory here.
I didn't go for a pin, so yeah, game. Good job.
Nice move. You know,
look at this. Stone Cold Steve
there
Austin
he
thinks he's in charge here, JR.
Yeah, but I think the Bret Hart's got other ideas.
Ooh.
Hart trying to get control of the match now.
Bret Hart going for another bulldog.
Get out of my face. Yeah, my
man,
face.
This, JR, both men down.
Told you, I know how to do it. Oh, and ringside shit.
Oh, all right. I think this man means business.
All right, you meet me outside because I go. What? I'm going to wake my signature. So.
Oh, this spells bam. Well, the trick sometimes when you get outside the ring is survival. The match becomes almost secondary
I'm
when you get there.
Not gonna wake my
objects.
Finisher. Okay, reverse
and
me all you want.
From Bret Hart.
Oh,
shit down.
That was a heavy shot.
You know what? You
go.
Can get
back
yourself.
Inside the ring.
I don't care if you get carried out. Are you seriously that hurt that you can't get in the ring?
He's bringing it back inside the ring now.
Okay, I went for the.
Steve Austin doing a great job of turning that around.
Gunner.
Stone Cold Stunner. Hey, this may very well be it. Two.
What? Oh my God! Bret kicked out. Man, this guy.
And friends and neighbors, that's one heck of a punch.
Oh, wait, nice reversal. And now Bret Hart pushing forward.
Oh, he got him.
Really pushing
come
his
on.
Opponent to the limit
come on.
Here.
You guys saw the 316. So, let's get the guy down.
Rinse and repeat. There it is again.
There you go.
Alright,
I got pre-form a charge.
Oh, man, what a matchup game. This has been physical all the way through.
But I tell you, I think Stone Cold
no
Steve
way.
Austin's got to be asking himself, what does he have to do to beat Bret Hart? Can he do it? Oh, look at this.
Austin with that version of the million-dollar dream, but it's countered by Hart. Hart shoulders down and Bret the Hitman Hart countered Austin and pins the Rattlesnake. Hart has earned a shot now at the WWE Champion.
Man, oh man, Stone Cold Steve Austin had that
had that finishing maneuver locked in, but he wouldn't let go when Hart was on the ropes. That's what really cost him the victory.
The million-dollar dream cost Austin maybe $1 million. This rivalry is far from over. I guarantee you that, by God.
How did we lose? What? Oh, this is a bonus match, if you guys didn't know. No, it's not. They usually do it, but this must be a... No pinfalls. No countouts. Who will be... Oh, this was a submission match. I remember this. Okay, let's continue. I know that some people don't like my license at like hour long, but hey, it's just license.
Well, I hate to bring this up, King, but Bret Hart took a little turn on you when he knocked you on your keister.
Yeah, and I didn't appreciate it one bit. Let me tell you, I think Bret Hart was out.
Wait, who?
Doing that.
Oh, he's in here. Okay.
For the abusive obscenities.
What's that? Is he on?
There's absolutely no excuse for that. No matter how much
get
this
the
man.
Fuck. Oh, I thought we were taking him out.
Well, well, you almost caught him the son of a...
No, I didn't.
Well, look out. Here we go. Steve Austin can feel the momentum swinging his way.
Why do we have a guest referee? I can't even remember who this guy is.
As we speak.
Oh, barricade? Man, get out of my ring. Alright, all we have
remember,
to do is...
Our guest here. Is only here to officiate the match, not get involved.
Okay, Brett.
I believe that when I see it.
Shane McMahon.
How in the world did he counter that?
Come on. Get into that barricade, boy. Wait, where I get into
really
that?
It's hard to imagine what's going through the
me.
Head of our guest here. They may be having
oh,
a
yeah, there's
hard
no count
staying outs. Out of this matchup.
Wait, I wonder if, is this a no disqualification?
The one way
you know is, like, you get a weapon and the freaking referee takes it out. Let's see. Nope, it's not a no disqualification, actually.
Remember,
okay,
our guest here is only here
cracks him with the chair.
Keep going.
Oh, that chair has got to hurt. And bashes him with the chair. It's over. That's got to be it.
You guys like that sound? Like my brother. Like.
Oh, lights out. When he gets going like this, there are a few better.
Okay.
He's just lethal with that thing.
Out.
Oh,
there we go.
Steve Austin.
All right. Get that ass out. Charge that finisher up.
Oh, you better be careful, Stone Cold. Oh!
Austin,
if he knocks Brett out, Brett can't say I quit.
This I Quit match, Ken Shamrock, the referee. We are in Chicago. This is WrestleMania 13. Neither Austin or the Hitmen have ever submitted in their professional careers. It's all on the line here. A lot of pride. Who's the alpha male? Nice leg sweep by the Hitman.
And this crowd is going wild, JR. They're waiting to hear one of these superstars say they quit.
You got to think that the Hitman is thinking sharpshooter.
Focusing no.
on the leg of Stone Cold Steve Austin.
Uh-oh, this is not going to be good for the Rattlesnake. Oh, man.
Oh, my God. Oh, this must hurt.
Figure four using that ring post as leverage. Shamrock trying to free Stone Cold. And Austin, damage has been done. Austin in a bad, bad way.
But he still will not say he quits.
This is an I Quit match? I never knew that, dude. Like, I never saw this match before, but I know the history of Stone Cold.
And you can find yourself in a world of hurt.
Oh, yeah, we have to do the same thing we did last time.
He doesn't want to do this.
Boy,
outside the ring.
Get over here. Like, you're gone. You're gone.
Oh, look at this, JR.
All right.
And I'm telling you, Stone Cold Steve Austin. Oh, look out! No! Inverted atomic drop.
And Austin, that's a low blow, technically. Again, a no disqualification match. Referee Ken Shamrock helpless to do anything about it. Now what's the Hitman doing?
Look out.
Steel chair. Bret Hart bringing a steel chair in the ring.
It's
as legal as a wrist lock.
Things are about to get ugly.
Oh! Right to the leg. Austin in trouble.
Oh, no.
Hart's got evil intentions.
This is going to be damn bad, JR. This is going to be real bad. Oh, look at this. This is going to be... Wait a minute. Bret Hart took too long. Stone Cold got a chair.
Oh, man. The steel chair.
My God.
Right in the spine.
Okay, leg.
Victoria, Texas.
Oh, look at Austin. He's begging Bret Hart
get
to get back to his
up.
Feet. And that, look out, JR. Austin's got that chair.
Austin keeping his word. He said he was going to beat the hell out of Hart. And he's doing it. That steel chair. Nothing the referee can do about it. The stakes are high.
I'm not so certain that this match we called right down the middle.
What will it actually give?
This
I actually like that. But...
submission hold and used to great effect here. After a move like that, he's going to need a chiropractor in the near future.
Wait, Tranga, where you going? I can get my act, but not really. But
making bigger and bigger impact. Perfectly executed.
Okay, get that chair because you got him, Bret.
It's all over but the shouting.
Okay.
Oh, that's gonna put an end to this one. What a debilitating smash with that chair.
Damn.
It's showing no signs of letting up.
Again with the move, dude. I pressed the wrong thing. My bad.
The Hitman's been busted wide open.
Yeah.
What an amazing match here at WrestleMania 13. The Hitman, Bret Hart, trying to lock in the Sharpshooter King. You know how that feels.
Will he tap?
Deadly painful.
Oh my gosh, and Bret Hart hasn't cinched in. Stone Cold Steve Austin, I don't think he's got any choice, JR. He's going to have to say, I quit.
Austin a long way from the ropes. He can't reach the ropes.
He won't.
Referee Ken Shamrock right down in Austin's face to hear him say, I quit. Austin in a bad, bad way, obviously.
Wait a minute.
Bret got off balance. Bret lost his balance there. Lost his leverage, but he didn't relinquish the hold.
Oh, he's still got it locked in and now applying even more pressure.
An amazing display of guts.
Listen to Shamrock. He's saying, Austin, do you quit? Do you quit?
Shamrock's done an amazing job officiating this match. Austin has passed out.
That's it.
Austin is unconscious.
As a result of Stone Cold Steve Austin losing consciousness, the winner of this bout, Bret.
He never said it.
The match is over. The referee has stopped it. Austin cannot continue. And there's no reason for Bret Hart to continue this onslaught. He's won the match, but he's frustrated that he couldn't make Austin say, I quit.
He's going to try to put that sharpshooter on again. Shamrock. Look at Shamrock.
Shamrock with a takedown. Waistlock takedown. And Shamrock will fight you, Bret. He will fight you right now. Bret Hart showing no sportsmanship whatsoever after winning this controversial match here at WrestleMania 13.
Well, Bret Hart wins, but Stone Cold Steve Austin just too stubborn to say, I quit.
And this crowd chanting, Austin, Austin. Man, we come in here, Hart was the fan favorite. Austin was the enemy. They leave in different roles.
Stunner!
Austin on one leg. You never trust a rattlesnake.
Never.
They don't make good corporate pets, let me tell you. Austin on one leg. Refused to say I quit.
In the wake of WrestleMania 13, as audiences began to gravitate towards Stone Cold Steve Austin, a dark cloud began to form. separating the hitman from fans south of the Canadian border.
First of all, I want to apologize.
What?
To all my great fans in Canada.
For what?
And to you, my fans right here across the United States of America, I apologize for nothing. You take a gunless creep like Stone Cold Steve Austin and beat him to a bloody pulp, even though you all know that he lost, you cheer him on the way back to the dressing room like he won. You don't respect me. Well, the fact is, the American wrestling fans can kiss my ass.
Let me clear the air because I never, ever said I quit.
Austin never gave up! Austin never gave up!
You never got the job done.
As Bret Hart's relationship with the American fans continued to crumble,
Americans don't give a damn about family.
The hitman would turn to his family to forge a new foundation.
I'm asking you for your help, because I need you.
It would take more than numbers to rattle the rattlesnake.
I'm finished with you.
You'll have to kill me to be finished with me.
The only way I'm going to get Stone Cold Steve Austin off my back is to end his career.
Like a pack of wolves!
One of these days,
April 20th at In Your House,
I'm going to look down at your grave. Here lies Bret the Hitman Hart. Because Steve Austin ripped his pink and black and that's the bottom line. Because Stone Cold said so.
A beast right there. No one can stop Stone Cold. Alright, well, this is the last. Well, we'll continue in the next episode. Don't forget to subscribe for more content. Comment below. Like the video if you want. Just don't forget to, tune in later because I will be doing some stuff later, I'm pretty sure. If I don't do stuff later, that means I don't have the time, so, yeah. Alright, I'll talk to y'all later, alright?